Hello, Howard.
Hello，
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. Yes.
Good, you sound good today. Your sound is working. Did you fix it?
Yes, I use
Earphones?
I may let me think. Earphone, yes, earphone.
You are using your earphones now.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Right. And how was school, Howard? Did you write any tests yet?
Yes, next week.
Oh, your tests are next week. What are you
Yeah.
writing, Howard?
Writing.
What
What's mean?
subjects?
So what subject?
Maths, physics.
Math, Chinese, English, and I don't know how to say.
Maths, English, Chinese. Okay.
This
And which subject? A biology. Okay.
okay.
Which subject is very hard for you at the moment, Howard?
Maybe math.
Maths is tough. Okay. Do you
Yes.
go for extra lessons?
Yes, lessons.
Hmm.
What's mean?
Do you go for like a tutor? Does a tutor help you?
No.
Okay, but it's very tough. And you are writing next week, so are you studying this weekend?
Yes.
Okay. So, Howard, I just want to say hello to Kathy. Hello, Kathy.
Hello.
Hi, it's my first time meeting you. How are you doing?
Good.
That's good.
Because our school, yesterday have exam and today is finished.
Oh, yay! Yeah, so you are done with your exams. No more studying for you. Which one was really hard, Kathy? Which subject?
English.
Was it English?
Yes.
Wow, okay. How long have you been studying English for, Kathy? How long have you been taking classes for English?
Taking class. It's at school.
No, like here, like now. How long have you been doing classes?
Last month.
Oh, since last month. Okay, so it was tough for you. All right. And Kathy, tell me a little bit about yourself. How old are you? What are you studying? And what are your favorite hobbies or what do you like to do, Kathy?
I am grade 10. And I like to play basketball and volleyball.
Lovely. Basketball and volleyball. Did you know Taiwan? I think Taiwan won the basketball game recently. Is that true? Taiwan. Did you hear about that?
It's baseball.
Was it baseball? Oh, sorry, my apologies. So that was baseball. Okay. And what is your favorite thing to do on the weekend, Kathy?
Ride a bike.
Riding bikes. Okay. You like to ride a bike. Good. Okay. And all right. So, favorite movie?
I haven't. I didn't see movie.
Okay.
This day.
Okay, so nothing. What type of movies do you like, Kathy? Do you like a horror? Do you like Avengers? Do you like comedies? What type of
Horror,
movie?
horror.
You like horror movies? Oh, I see. Okay. That's horror. Okay. So you haven't watched any of these movies yet that you see on my screen?
No.
So I want you to watch Tarot. If you like horror movies, please watch this movie. It's called Tarot. I think you would like it. It's a very scary movie if you like scary movies. Okay. Harry, I just want to say hello to Harry. How are you doing today?
I'm great.
That's awesome. Are you still in the middle of your tests and exams? How's it going?
And today I have a big test, have a small test. Next week I have a big test.
Okay, so you are still studying, and what has been the most difficult subject for you yet, Harry?
History.
History. Okay. Do you find it a problem to remember, like when you're studying? What do you find is the problem for you? Is it hard to remember dates or
Yes, it's
people?
hard to remember.
Okay. So do you, when you are studying, do you take breaks, like go out for a walk, get something to eat?
Yes.
Do you try to do that?
Yes.
So the best thing I found that helps you to remember is when you're studying late at night. I know everybody loves to study till 1 a.m. or 2 a.m., but what I found really helped me is go to bed a little bit earlier, study what you need to study. But on the day of your exam, right? Let's say you've studied history up until the night before. When you go to bed, try and wake up like an hour or two earlier, even if it means you're waking up at 4 a.m., Harry, and then just go over your history at from about 4 a.m. It does something to the brain and it helps you reinforce. That means it actually makes you remember things better. So when you wake up early hours of the morning and you study, it actually helps you to remember things better. Have you heard that before or have you tried that before?
Never try.
Never tried.
I will try next.
Please try it. Just choose a subject because I see that helped a lot of people. That also helped me. Even if you feel you've studied enough, but just wake up a little bit earlier, like an hour or two earlier, and revise. Go over your work because you're fresh for the day, and then you're going to write that exam or that paper, and you will remember because it's fresh in your memory in the morning. Okay, I hope
Okay,
that'll
I
help
will
you.
try.
Good.
Yes,
That
I
goes
will try.
for Howard as well, because Howard is still studying. Also, Harry, what did you get to do this weekend? Or are you planning to do anything this coming weekend?
I also studied, and I will take a break in during play basketball in
Ah,
this
good.
week.
Okay, so at least you're going to have a break and play some basketball.
Yes.
Okay, all right, good. Kathy, what are you planning to do this weekend? Since you're finished with your exams, you're finished with schoolwork, what are you planning to do?
I want to go my friend's school. Their school birthday.
What are they having?
School birthday.
A school bus day.
Birthday.
A school birthday. And what are you going to do there at the school?
Hing Ju.
Is it like a flea market, like a food?
Yeah, free market.
Ah, and you're going to buy lots of stuff to eat.
I don't have money.
Oh, you're going to window shop, Kathy, because you don't have money. So you're
Yeah.
going.
I just want to go to see my friend.
Okay. Just to see your friend. Okay, that's good. So last week I asked everybody in the lesson, what were their plans or what do you do for Christmas? Kathy, do you do anything special for Christmas? Does your family do anything special? Like Christmas traditions, do you put up a Christmas tree? Does the family get together for lunch or dinner? Do you exchange gifts with anyone? How do you celebrate Christmas?
Maybe have dinner.
Okay, so everybody has dinner at your home, Kathy?
Yeah.
And do you do gift exchanges? Do you exchange
Oh,
gifts?
exchange.
Okay. Do you do that with family or
Yeah, and classmate.
Oh, you do it with family and your classmates.
Yes.
Lovely. Okay, good. All right. So today I'm going to ask all of you, we're going to do a little exercise, right? Because I'm always hearing from the students about, oh, you need to try this dessert or you need to try this food. Does everybody know what stinky tofu is?
Yes.
Stinky tofu. Okay. So I've been told it's very, very tasty. What are your thoughts on stinky tofu, Harry?
And smell bad, but it tastes good.
Yes, that's what everybody says. It smells bad, but it tastes good. So I'm going to ask each of you a question. Sort of to get an idea because everybody's different, everybody has their own opinions and ideas of what's nice for them. So, Harry, think of me as one of your best friends that you haven't seen in a very long time. And I'm coming to Taiwan, right? And you're super excited. So, what would you tell me is the best place to have dinner? The best food to have if I'm coming to Taiwan. You
Maybe
can
bubble
say,
milk tea is
sorry.
famous in and bubble milk tea is famous in Taiwan.
Boba milk tea. Is this
Yes.
okay? Is this dessert, Harry? Is
Yes.
this dessert? Okay. So, but if I want to have dinner,
Ah, dinner.
yes, where would I go? Where would you take me? You can say the name to, of the restaurant, so maybe Kathy and Howard, y'all can get some ideas. It's nice to know what each student or each person's idea of good things are or good places. So, Harry, where would we go for dinner? Tasty, yummy meal. So basically, your favorite restaurant or street market or food.
I don't have an idea now.
You want me to come back to you?
Okay.
Okay, Kathy. Say I'm your best friend and you haven't seen me in years and I'm coming to Taiwan. Where would you take me for dinner?
I don't know how to say in China, in English.
Okay, you can say it in Chinese. Maybe Harry and Howard know the place. And what do they serve? What do they give? What is their dish?
This is eat. Meat.
What's the name of the restaurant?
Hong Zhi Zhi.
Okay, I won't be able to spell that. Harry, do you know this place? Howard, do you know this place?
Yeah, yes.
And okay, thanks, Kathy. Howard, what do they serve in this place?
It is let me think.
Is it noodles? Is it
Yeah.
hot? Steak.
Yeah, yeah, steak
I
and noodle.
the noodle.
Iron plate. Is it called iron plate, guys?
Yeah. I have a noodle and meat.
Yummy. Okay, thank you. That was interesting. Okay, so Howard, if I'm coming to Taiwan and I'm your best friend, you haven't seen me for years, where would you take me for dinner? What's your favorite restaurant?
I very my they know, but this is in the USA happen.
What is it called, Howard?
In USA, you can maybe have,
McDonald's.
yeah.
You would take me to McDonald's for dinner, Howard?
I like.
That's okay. What you like, that's fine. Harry, do you remember the name of your restaurant now?
Yes.
Okay, what is it?
Din Tai Fung.
Wee! Okay, how do you spell it?
I can't. I check.
Sure.
I type a message.
Typing. Okay, let's get your message there. Hi, Nina.
Hi.
How
nice
are you?
To meet you. Yeah, I'm good.
We were just talking about our favorite restaurants to have dinner. And Harry told me Din Tai Fung.
Oh.
Din Tai Fung. Does everybody know that place?
Yes.
It's a famous brand restaurant in Taiwan. Yeah, also famous around the world.
Ah, very nice. Thank you, Harry. Okay, Nina, since you just joined, if I am your best friend, but you haven't seen me in years, and I'm coming to Taiwan, where would you take me for dinner?
I will take her to our night market to enjoy. We can eat some street food. Yeah, well, our street food is very it's a taste good, not delicious, but it tastes good. Yeah.
Not delicious, but it is good. I'm sure it looks stunning. It looks very delicious on TV. All right. So thank you for that, Nina. Right. Howard, If I'm your best friend, you haven't seen me for years, and I'm coming to Taiwan, where would you take me to hang out? Like with the friends, we'd all go together and hang out. Where would we go? Like a coffee shop for jazz? So what place do you go with your friends?
Let me think. Go out. Maybe. Do you know 101 吗？那个。
What's the place's name?
In Taipei, it have a
101. What is? Oh, okay, you're
this
gonna miss.
is a big you can then
What can you do there, Howard? Can you play Luca? Can you listen to music? What can you play?
In Taipei.
Building 101, guys. Has anyone heard of Building 101?
Yes. Building up 101, you can stop the Taipei city.
Beautiful. Wow. Okay. So that's a place we could go relax. And it's also a big tourist destination. You could take lovely photos there. I see it's very, very nice. Thank you, Howard. Kathy, same question, Kathy. Where would we go to relax or hang out? What is your type of place that you go out with your friends?
Jiayi, in Taiwan, Jiayi.
Oh, interesting. Can you spell that for me?
I check it.
Sorry, AI?
I check.
Okay, you're gonna check. Harry, Nina, you can think about the same question. We'll come to you.
C-H-I-A-Y-I.
C-H-A-Y. Am I getting it right?
C-H-I.
C-H-I. A-Y.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah. And what can you do here, Kathy?
There is many delicious food.
It looks beautiful. Is that a train? You can take a train there?
You can take the train to travel on the Ali Mountain. And you can solve the when sprint, you can solve the cherry blossom on the mountain.
Wow, cherry blossoms on the mountain. It's so beautiful. How many times have you been there, Kathy?
I can't count.
Many times, I see.
Yeah, many.
Do you go with friends or with family?
With family.
With family. Thank you for that.
Yeah, and there you also you can saw the sunrise.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's a famous sunrise viewer on the Ali Mountain in Chai.
So in Chai, can you stay overnight and watch the sunrise?
Yes.
Accommodation is there. Beautiful. All right, thank you. Harry, what is your ideal place? What's the name
maybe
of your
also ideal? Maybe also Taipei.
Taipei, is that Taipei City? What's in Taipei?
Um,
What do you like to do here, Harry? It's beautiful.
Maybe in the night, have a very beautiful scenery, and there have many oh and some of the best in college and love to go there because we have a senior high school and we have this 3 years of the graduation, so we have to check some college we have to go.
Where to go?
Yes.
Okay, so Taipei City is the place that you go all often, Harry?
A little. Ever twice?
Twice. Okay.
Only twice.
Okay, but it looks very, very beautiful, clean, and very colorful. Definitely a place to visit. Thank you, Harry. Nina, where's your ideal place that you would take someone you haven't seen in many, many years to have fun? Where would you take them?
Have some.
You can take pictures, you can eat delicious food. Where would you take them?
I think I prefer Taipei too because you can hiking, you can eat, you can play, and you can
lots
do many things. Yeah, you have a lot of choice in Taipei, I think. Yeah, if you first time, I prefer Taipei City.
And if I'm new to Taipei or Taiwan, if I'm visiting, would it be expensive to go to Taipei? Is it cheaper or expensive, guys? Compared to Taiwan.
I think it's made it not very expensive, not very cheap.
Not very expensive, not very cheap. I got you. All right. Last question, Howard. Where would you take me to get the best dessert, the sweet, delicious, yummy dessert? Where would you go?
Yummy. What is dessert?
How do I explain dessert to Howard? Like a sweet treat, a cake, ice cream, something sweet.
Oh, okay.
After dinner. What is your favorite or place or something that you like?
I don't like to eat these, so I don't know.
Wow, you don't like desserts, Howard? Oh,
yeah.
Wow. Okay, interesting. All right. So after dinner, Howard, you would just have a cool drink. You won't have any cake or ice cream.
Ice cream, yes. But
ice cream.
Dessert is no.
No. All right, interesting. Harry, where would you take me to get dessert?
And also not very like dessert, but I just eat a little.
You said earlier you like the boba milk tea. Is that about the only dessert you like? It's a milk
not
tea.
Favorite, but
Yes.
It is in Taiwan's famous.
Okay. Kathy, thanks, Harry. Kathy, what's your favorite place to have a sweet treat or dessert?
Like donut.
McDonald's?
Ice cream is good.
McDonald's ice cream. Okay. All right. So because our McDonald's ice cream is bad. It doesn't taste good. So I'm assuming in Taiwan it's good.
With tomato sauce.
Ice cream with tomato sauce. Kathy?
Yeah.
Did I hear you right? Wow. Okay.
It's
Is that
good.
something?
You can try next time.
I have to try it. It's put some tomato sauce with my ice cream. Okay. I'm going to try that. Very different, but interesting. I know they do a sweet potato ice cream. Have you heard of that at McDonald's, Kathy? Okay. I saw it on YouTube in Taiwan. Okay. Nina,
Yes.
your idea of ice cream, well, a dessert or a treat in Taiwan, what do you treat yourself to?
Idea of Taiwan have a Taiwan's drink shop. We have a break tea with ice cream.
Red tea. Nina, did I hear you right?
Yeah, red tea. Black. We also call black tea. Black
Black
tea with ice cream.
Aha. In Taiwan, is this a famous one that people?
I think it's famous one in the drink shop.
Oh, it looks good. That does look very good. Oh, it's like we call it an ice cream float. Okay. So it's tea with a big dollop of ice cream on it.
Yeah, drink, and they also dessert.
Very interesting. Okay, good. Thank you guys for sharing your ideas. I definitely have an idea now what to do when visiting Taiwan. All right. Now I have an interesting English exercise, guys. I always like to do a little bit of English exercises in our lessons. Does anyone know what is an antonym? Antonym. Shout if you know what an antonym is, guys. Kathy, Harry, Howard, antonyms are Nina.
Afternoon.
What is an antonym?
Like
So
similar means.
synonyms
Yes, similar
are,
means.
right, very good. Synonyms have similar meanings. Good job. Antonyms have opposite meanings, right? Antonyms are words that have the opposite meaning. Okay. Now, I would like each of you to give it a try. Okay, let's start with Howard. Can you give me an opposite word for fast?
Is slow.
Good job. Well done. Okay, we'll go this way. I'm looking at my screen. Kathy, old.
Young.
Good. Harry?
Beside.
The opposite of front?
Behind. Behind.
Behind. Got you. Nina?
That. Destined and now past. Past.
Okay. So the opposite of last is?
Past.
Did I hear you right first?
Oh, yeah, first.
What did you say, Nina? I didn't hear you there.
Yeah, first. Or after you.
Okay. Howard, opposite of early is
Oh, lately.
late. So
Yeah.
early Okay, early, you could say late or lately. Very good. Kathy, four. Opposite of full is?
I don't know.
Okay, let's do begin, Kathy. The opposite of begin?
Finish.
Finish. Good job. Right. Harry, do you think you could do full? Opposite?
Lacking. Lacking.
Lacking.
Lacking.
You could say lacking or you could say empty. It's not full, it's empty. Good job. Nina, accept.
Reject.
Excellent. Good job. Howard, allow. Howard, you there? Allow.
Sorry, I know.
The up.
Yes.
Allow.
Allow. Allow. I know mean
You can do it the opposite. So if I'm not allowing you, or you are not allowed, then you are.
cannot didn't can't can can't yeah. I know it
Okay. So the opposite of allow is.
Let me see.
So you can be allowed access, or you could be.
I don't know.
Okay, that's fine. Do you want to do arrive? The opposite of arrive.
What? Right.
Arrive
Hello?
to the when you arrive to the party, and when you like going away, what's the other word of arrive? The
Oh,
opposite.
I know all wrong. Is all wrong? Is this?
Let's see. Prohibit. So, okay. So this is the opposite of allow. We would say prohibit. Good word. You can also say deny. Okay, good job. Kathy, the opposite of arrive.
I don't
Kathy. Who wants to take a shot at arrive? Okay, Kathy, can you do sick?
know. Health.
Healthy. Good job. Harry, do you want to try arrive? Opposite meaning? Opposite word?
What? Depart.
Excellent job. Depart. Nina, I'm not nervous. I am.
Yeah.
Oof. I am. I'm not nervous. I am.
Perceived.
Was your what?
Positive.
Positive? Okay. So, well, normally, okay, we could use positive. I would say calm as well. Howard, can you do serious? The opposite of serious?
Serious.
This is a tough one, guys. If I'm not serious, I am.
I am. Let me serious. This word.
Okay, let's come back to serious and attack. Those words are quite difficult.
Yes.
Flighty. Okay, I've never heard this word flighty before. What does flighty mean? Howard, are you Googling it?
Yes, I'm Googling. Yes.
Okay. I'm not sure what flighty means, but I'll put it here under serious. Flighty, maybe it's a different word that I'm not sure. Kathy, can you do the opposite of bottom? If it's not at the bottom, it's So if it's not at the bottom, it's at the
I know that, but I don't know how to say.
But
is it anybody?
Top.
Top. Okay, I've heard top. Okay, we could do top. Harry, think. The opposite of think. Somebody's Googling. It's fine. He's up.
I know a check.
You know attack? You can do attack, Harry.
Yes, support.
Support. Yes. Instead of attacking, we would support them. Good job. Nina, can you do think?
Think.
I think is hard. Let's do calm. The opposite of calm is
comes or oh, never also nervous
it's
or
nervous.
yeah.
Also, we could also say anxious.
Negative, yes, anxious. Oh.
Anxious. So if I'm not calm, I'm either nervous or anxious about something. All right. Howard, the opposite of cold is
hot.
Hot. Kathy, the opposite of loud. Again, if you're not loud, you are Kathy, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Okay. So what do you think it means? If you're not loud, you are
quiet.
Quiet. You could use quiet. You could use soft. Good job. Harry, can you take a hit with think? If I'm not
reject.
Thinking.
Maybe reject. Reject.
Reject. Okay. So if I'm not thinking, I could reject. Or that is a difficult one, but I'll give it to you. All right, guys. Well done. Good work, everybody. That was very, very good. I wanted to touch a little bit on homophones, but we will do that next week because we don't have time. Does anyone know what homophones mean without looking at my screen? Anybody? If you look at just these words, what do you think a homophone is? By just looking at it, what do you think it is?
It's spelled like
similar.
Like same.
Similar. Very good.
Oh.
So homophones sound similar, but they have totally different meanings, like sell and sell. I'm going to sell you a jersey, and the other cell is my cell phone. Good job, guys. But that we're going to do next week because we have to get to our video now. And let me put the video up for you. All right. Very interesting topic, everybody, on design. Okay. The world is poorly designed. Copying nature helps. So I think in this video, we're going to learn about how we've come to copy nature to improve our designs on everyday things or items that we use or machines. Everybody, can I ask you all to be on mute while I put the video on and we can watch the video and talk about it after. Okay, guys, here we go. Let me get to my screen.
In 1989, Japan's Shinkansen bullet train had a problem. It was fast, really fast, like pushing 170 miles per hour fast. But every time it exited a tunnel, it was loud. The noise was coming from a variety of sources, but whenever a train sped into a tunnel, it pushed waves of atmospheric pressure through the other end. The air exited tunnels with a sonic boom that could be heard 400 meters away. In dense residential areas, that was a huge problem. So an engineering team was brought in to design a quieter, faster, and more efficient train. And they had one secret weapon. Eiji Nakatsu, the general manager of the technical development department, was a bird watcher. Different components of the redesigned bullet train were based on different birds. Owls inspired the pantograph. That's the rig that connects the train to the electric wires above. Nakatsu modeled the redesign after their feathers, reducing noise by using the same serrations and curvature that allow them to silently swoop down to catch prey. The Adelie penguin, whose smooth body allows it to swim and slide effortlessly, inspired the pantograph's supporting shaft, redesigned for lower wind resistance. And perhaps most notable of all was the kingfisher. The kingfisher is a bird that dives into water to catch its prey. The unique shape of its beak allows it to do that while barely making a splash. Nakatsu took that shape to the design table. The team shot bullets shaped like different train nose models down a pipe to measure pressure waves and drop them into water to measure the splash size. The quietest nose design was the one modeled most closely after the kingfisher's beak. When the redesign debuted in 1997, it was 10% faster, used 15% less electricity, and stayed under the 70 decibel noise limit in residential areas. And it did all that with the wings of an owl, the belly of a penguin, and the nose of a kingfisher. There's a name for design like this. It's called biomimicry.
The people who design our world usually never take a biology class. Believe it or not. So they're novices in how the world works.
That's Janine Benyus. Back in 1997, she wrote the book that coined the term biomimicry. It told the story of the innovations in computing, energy, and health that were inspired by structures in the natural world.
Stick like a gecko, compute like a cell, even run a business like a redwood forest.
Benyus has since worked as a consultant for various companies, trying to get them to understand how to take design ideas from nature. That might mean studying prairie dog burrows to build better air ventilation systems, mimicking shark skin to create bacteria-resistant plastic surfaces for hospitals, or arranging wind turbines in the same drag-reducing pattern that schools of fish swim in. Designers get inspiration from a lot of different places, but Benyus thinks many of them could benefit from looking more at the natural world.
So there's a lot of sort of looking at what other people have done, and what they do is they look at all the others and they get ideas. They literally do, you know, a lot of designers have lots of magazines that they look through. They tear those out and they put them on inspiration boards. But they're looking at other human technologies.
Her idea was simple. Designers should get in the habit of bringing a biologist to the table and let them help solve problems by mimicking nature. And there are three main ways they can do that.
You know, you can mimic it, its form or its shape. You might create a paint for a building that when it dries, it's got the same structure as self-cleaning leaves. Lotus leaves are notoriously great. They let rainwater clean the leaf because they have these bumps. The rainwater balls up on the bumps and then it pearls away the dirt. So that lotus effect is physical. And you can create a physical structure on the outside of any product. Imagine that on the outside of your car. Rainwater would clean your car. So that's mimicking form. But there's also mimicking process, the processes in the natural world. It might even be, you know, how you mimic how ants communicate in order to efficiently find sources of food or new places to live. And those processes, that self-organization, has been mimicked in software, you know, in things like, you know, autonomous cars and how they're going to move in flocks through the city by talking to one another. That's mimicking nature's process. And then you jump up to the level of mimicking whole ecosystems, right? There's a thing called, that's a buzzword right now that's really hot, called the circular economy, which is essentially, you know, industry saying, you know, there should be no such thing as a byproduct in our manufacturing facility that goes to landfill. It should be used by something else. Right. And at the end of a product's life, that product should be upcycled into something else. It's being called the circular economy. Ecosystems do that really, really, really well. You've got a log on the forest floor, and those materials move up into the body of the fungus that eats it. Those materials move up into a mouse. And that mouse material moves up into a hawk, right? And if you think about that as what we'd like to do with local materials being upcycled constantly in our cities, for instance, those ecosystem lessons are really big for us.
And that's the end goal for biomimetic design, making products, systems, and cities functionally indistinguishable from the natural world. Life has been around on Earth for 3.8 billion years. And what designers are starting to realize is that that is a lot of research and development time.
The people who design our world have a lot to learn from the natural world. All they have to do is take a look.
Thank you so much for watching. This is one of a series of videos that we're doing in collaboration with.
Very, very interesting. I really like that video. All right. Harry, what are your thoughts on this video? What did you understand? What was the main idea here?
We cover the animal shape to doing well. And like Japan, and Japan's organizational second sense cause probably projects because it was too noise. Later, Japan studied a new second sense that intimates the shape of animals to reduce various difficulty.
100%. So the designers took the idea from the bird to make that bullet train softer or quieter, but also faster. Okay. Have you been to Japan, Harry? Have you seen this train?
No.
Okay. But I've heard it's very, very loud. Okay. I mean, very, very fast. Kathy, what are your thoughts on this video? Thanks, Harry.
The trend is use to
Okay, take your time. Do you think they get do our designers copy a lot of ideas from nature, from animals?
Yes.
And what was the main thing, I think, in this video? What stood out for you? What did you find very interesting here in this video?
The rain. The water. And yes.
The kingfisher, yes. The kingfisher. And how it swooped in the water and they copied that design of the beak. Very interesting. Okay. Nina, did you enjoy this video? Anything you found very interesting here?
Yeah, you can find the many animals that they use it on your life. For example,
What animal you found interesting in the video, and the way we copy its life, its way, the way it does things. Anything stick out for you?
I forget. Not just not just animals, like plant,
The
like
mushroom.
yeah. For example, you can like raincoat, maybe like a such a plant. Product the clothes.
Very interesting. Howard, that's fine. Nina, have you been to Japan? Have you been on that train?
Yes, yeah, JR.
Is it quiet? Is it very fast and very quiet?
Yeah, I think it's very quiet. And
Okay.
yeah.
Right.
And very cute. Cute.
So the design is very cute. Something also they copied from the birds, from nature. All right.
Their appearance.
Appearance, yes.
Yes, very cute. Sometimes come on, come on, no, come on,
Come,
on.
command.
Yeah.
You enjoy the design of the train. Okay.
Yeah.
And because you yourself also enjoy design, do you like you do like art and design
Yeah.
yourself?
Yes.
So you appreciate the appearance of the train.
The trend is a fast, a quick, and on time. And the service is very, very good.
Very good. Oh, wow. It's beautiful.
And very
Okay.
clean.
It's very clean, right?
Clean inside.
Interesting. Before we run out of time, Howard, what did you like about the video, Howard? And also, have you been on this Shinkansen train?
I only think sometimes nature is very cool.
You think it's very cool. Okay.
Yeah.
And have you been to Japan before, Howard?
Yes, but I don't see, I don't take it.
You haven't
Yeah.
been on the train.
I
Okay.
don't have it. I don't have it.
Okay, that's fine. And from the video that you watched, did you find anything interesting there about nature and our designs?
His header is maybe
The shape of the train, the bullet.
a very I don't know how to say it.
Very pointed or very sharp.
Yeah, yes.
And it looks very smart. Okay. So when you went to Japan, Howard, how did you travel? If you did not take the train, then how did you get around in Japan?
Bus, yes, I yeah, bus.
The bus. Okay, interesting. So All right. Harry, have you been to Japan? Have you been on this train?
No.
Okay. But do you like the design of this train?
It's very cool.
It's very cool. Okay, very interesting, very cool. I would definitely want to go on a train like that. Kathy, have you been to Japan?
Yeah, I have.
And how do you travel in Japan? How do you get around to the places in Japan? Do you take the bus or the scooter, or are you on the
MRC, MRT.
Oh, you take the MRT.
Yeah.
Okay, Kathy, is the MRT different to the bullet train, or are they the same?
Because it's my when I am young, so
Or when you were younger. All
yeah.
right. Okay. All right. So is the MRT faster or slower than the bullet train?
I forgot.
Harry, do you know? Because I hear MRT all the time. Is it slower or faster than the.
Fast.
It's fast.
Yes.
Compared to the Shinkansen? Which one is
Slow than
fast?
Shinkansen.
Shinkansen is
Slowly.
fast, is slower.
Yes.
Oh, so the MRT is quicker. Interesting. Okay, guys, we actually have went over our time. I couldn't get a chance to do our reading exercise, but we will do that next week. Thank you, everybody, for joining me today. Good luck, Harry and Howard, on your tests and your exams. It was nice to meet you, Kathy, and have a good week, Nina. Thank you guys so much. See you next week. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.